Hello. Let us see in this module some essential components of simulation. Objects, precision, type of reality, sequence, number of solutions, time frame, and role of the learner are some components which should be taken care in designing simulation. Basically, in simulation, we play with some objects. Either these objects are modeled or maybe in the form of images, but the learner needs to deal with all these models, all these objects. For example, if we are talking about a virtual lab, then there may be some physics equipment. If there is a real human being along with these models, then the simulation becomes more complex, because there is some change in the objects as well as there can be some changes in that human character. Precision is another component. Precision refers to how well we understand the processes being simulated, how precisely the entire process is to be simulated. Is there a presence or an absence of people as objects? More the number of considerations, less precise the model becomes. And then it is very hard to program the simulation. Wherever there is precision, then we know exactly how the simulation will work. Now here you can see that there are some objects such as various states of matter. And as we go on increasing heat, or if we provide cold environment by putting ice, or if we reduce volume by pressing lever, then the state of matter changes. How precisely this will happen will depend on program behind this entire simulation. Other component is type of reality. This reality refers to whether the phenomenon depicted is the one that occurs in real world or not. Depending on the relationship between the real world and its representation or simulation, there can be three levels of reality. In real world, phenomena may be occurring exactly as simulated, or phenomena do occur in the real world, but those are not exactly as simulated. In third case, the entire phenomena may be imaginary, which do not occur in real world at all. But this kind of phenomena are designed so as to build some logic and some problem solving situation for the learner. Even the sequence of events is important in simulation. The sequence refers to whether the events occur in linear, cyclic, or more complex fashion. There may be a situation where the entire sequence of events is linear, so this event should be performed in one way. Or there may be a cycle of events where the events occur again and again. There may be some complex situations where order of events are not strictly definable, or at the same time many different orders are possible. So learner's act may decide either the next very specific event that is in linear, sometimes it will get repeated that is in cyclic, and sometimes learner's decision will decide altogether different sequence of simulation. Depending on the nature of simulation, even the number of solutions may differ. In some cases, reality may vary with respect to the number of solutions available. There are certain situations where there is a definite procedure or the correct answer, and by simulating the environment, the learner will reach to that answer. But sometimes right or wrong answers are not possible, or there may be more than one solutions. And depending on exactly what learner is doing, learner will seek answer. For example, coming back to the matter, state of matter, whether the liquid turns into gas, whether the liquid turns into say solid, there is nothing right or wrong. It just shows in what circumstances matter is going to change the state and which state will be achieved. Time frame is another important component of simulation. This is the period of time over which a phenomenon normally takes place. The more extreme the time frame of the real phenomenon, less realistic the simulation model. You can clearly see here that the Earth is rotating around the Sun, the Moon is rotating around the Earth. Now, though the entire simulation happens in proportion, whatever happens in 1 year can be shown here in a few seconds. So it's deviating from realistic time frame, but it's explaining the concept very well. So in simulation, time may be speeded up or slowed down. If something is happening in a fraction of seconds in a particular chemistry experiment, to see exactly how that process is happening, we can slow down the time and we can show learners what all has happened in this one fraction of second. So modification of time helps in keeping simulation program interesting and most importantly useful for learning, effective in learning. Here you can see that the entire ecology is working so fast. You can even show evolution of human being from animal to human being in a few seconds, which may have actually occurred in millions and millions of years. Now, in all these simulations, role of the learner is very significant because the entire simulation is learner controlled. Constructivism works in simulation. So the learner has specific role to play. Learner can observe simulated objects from outside, or learner can be one of the objects of simulation. Learner can be either an actor or reactor. When the learner is actor, learner takes decision, and as per learner's decisions, as per learner's act, all objects react. Again, the same experiment on the state of matter, you can see that if learner is giving pressure, if learner is reducing volume, the state of matter will change. So the object will change, the state of molecules will change. Sometimes, whatever learner does, depending on learner's actions, the other objects react. For example, learner has forgotten here to put shampoo on baby and the baby has started crying. So these were some significant components of simulation. Thank you.